You're about to learn how to create awesome Scribble animations inside of DaVinci Resolve's fusion page where you can get really creative with.
But there's one more thing that I want to mention before we jump into this tutorial. And I just want to take a quick second to thank you for bringing me to 10,000 subscribers. And to celebrate this, I recently made a community post that I want to do a Q&A video where you can ask me whatever questions that you have regarding whatever topic. So if you have any questions, you can drop them below this video or go to the community page to the original post and post your questions there. And I will make sure to answer them. But now let's jump into this tutorial. First of all, I want you to drag your clip onto the timeline and then right click and select new fusion clip. With the new fusion clip selected, let's hop over into the fusion page. So those are all the nodes that you need in order to create such an effect. There's a background node, there's a paint node, and a soft glow node if you want the glowy neon effect. If you don't want the glowy neon effect, just get rid of the soft glow node. So for this example, I'm going to get rid of all the nodes and I'm going to get rid of the merge node and I'm going to build this from scratch. First of all, I want to grab a background node because we can't paint in thin air. We have to paint onto something. And this is where the background comes in handy. So with this background node selected, let's click on this paint icon to bring in a paint node. And as I mentioned before, if you don't want to have the glowy neon effect, you can leave it as is or hit shift spacebar and search for soft glow and click on add. Now with this all set up, let's grab the output of soft glow one and connect it into the output of media in one to create merge one. And as you can see, your image turns black. And that is because we have our background color assigned to black. In order to change that, click on background one, go to the inspector in the top right corner and drag down the alpha channel to zero. So with this being done, let's go to the first frame of our animation, click on the paint node, and we want to make sure that our stroke is set to multi-stroke, and that is the setting by default. So don't change that. Then we want to go into the inspector in the top right corner. There we have all the brush controls. We have the size and the softness. And we also have the color options. So first of all, we want to make the chasing animation around the ball. And in order to do that, we want to make our size a little bit smaller. You can go into the inspector in the top right corner, go to size and just drag that down ever so slightly. Or what you could do else is if you go into the viewer, hit Command or Alt and then click with your mouse, left click and drag to the right. Or to the left, you can increase or decrease the brush size. Keyboard shortcuts are the way to go, so make sure to learn them. Then we want to zoom into our image and we want to make the chasing animation around the ball. What I'm going to be doing is I'm going to set my start point at around here. Then I want to just paint a nice little stroke. With this being done, make sure to remember the ending part of your stroke. Then go forward one frame. And then create another little stroke. Then go forward to the next frame, create another little stroke, something like that. Go forward to the next frame and repeat this process until you're at the start, which was around here on your animation. Let's complete that process. But remember to take some time when you want to do animations like this, because the more time you take, the better the end result's gonna be. And at around here was where I started my animation. So now I want to change the color, so I'm going to go to the next frame. And what I want to do is some tutorials suggest to copy all of those nodes and paste it once again and then change the color on the next paint node, but that's not very efficient. So click on the paint node, and the good thing about the paint node is if it's set to multi-stroke, it will only focus on the frame that you're currently working on. So if I make my next animation a teal, I can start off just drag down my red channel in the inspector and then create my next stroke. Go to the next frame, repeat that process until I'm at the start of my animation. Go to the next frame and repeat that process once again. So, and at around this point in time, I want to change color once again. So I'm going to go to the next frame, change my color to a yellow, something like that. And now what I want to do is I want to start my animation right here, but I don't want to do a chasing animation. I want to start it right here. Then I'm going to paint just a little bit. Then I'm going to go to the next frame. I'm going to start at my original start, but I'm going to paint further. Something like that. I'm going to go to next frame, use my original start, and I'm going to paint further once again. go back to the next frame. I'm going to start off at the original start. I'm going to paint even further. So as you can see, it's not that hard, but remember to take some time when you do animations like this, because the end result's going to be worth it. So now that we finished this, we're going to move on to the next frame, and we have to paint around the ball in one line. So basically just make sure to outline the ball on one frame. Then go to the next frame and the next frame. So this seems to be the last frame before the ball's being kicked. So what I want to do now is I want to outline the ball once again. Then I'm going to go forward to the next frame, and right now is where the ball's being kicked. So I want to change my color back to white. So I'm going to increase my blue channel. And then I want to make some speed animations, some speed lines right here. Go to the next frame. Probably going to zoom out a little bit. Make some speed lines here. So let's set this back to fit and then watch back what we've created. Perfect. Right now we want to give the ball just a nice face, and I want to start my face when the yellow line finishes. So this is the last frame before the yellow line finishes around the ball. So I'm going to go to my next frame, and right here is where I want to make the face. So I'm going to zoom out quite a bit, something like that. And right now I want to choose a orange color for the face. Reduce the brush size for the eyes quite a bit, something like that. And let's just create some eyes, something like that. And let's create a mouth and maybe a tongue. Then in order to fill the tongue, let's increase our brush size quite a bit. Then go on to the next frame, reduce the brush size once again for the eyes, something like that. And then the mouth, and now the tongue. Increase the brush size so we don't have to take ages for painting out the tongue, something like that. Go to the next frame, decrease our brush size once again. Go back to the start and just watch this back. So this is how simple it is to create cool neon glow scribble animations in DaVinci Resolve's Fusion page.
So that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, as always, please consider leaving a like and a comment. This would mean a ton to me. But anyways, hope you're having a great day. See you next time. Bye.